Vandal and Lara fan, Silverline Industrial Sealy fan. This is a Brian Fana fans, 17s fan. He got from the group trip in January.
Yep.
So yeah, there is some paint that has peeled off at the bottom of the motor.
I'll show you guys.
Yeah, I'll just show you guys right here. Looks like rust even.
Yeah, it seems like there might be a little rust there.
But yeah, mine wasn't that bad, though. The paint peeling off, it wasn't rust, it was just the paint peeling off. And actually, Jeffrey Robinson still has my Silverline. He's currently repainting it. He says the blades are almost done. It needs another coat of paint.
Yeah.
But, yeah. So I guess we'll go ahead and start this fan on low. And this fan is dated 2001. And actually, this one looks like Jeffrey Robinson's Silverline because it's got the black washes on the lower and upper canopy.
Yeah.
I don't know when his was dated. I didn't check the sticker on his. Can't remember if I did. But, I don't know if his is from the late 90s or 2000.
I remember when we tested your silver line here.
Yeah, mine would definitely be from the early 90s, considering how it doesn't have the black washers on the lower and upper canopies. Oh, is this medium now?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's medium. It's making some noise.
Yeah, maybe it will need to be oiled at some point. It's kind of noisy. It's... Hopefully it won't, like, fall off its J-hook.
Yeah, but actually, Jeffrey's Silverline, he did put a new line around the motor on his, and it cut the down rod shorter. Now we're gonna do spin down. Since this is industrial, we'll get a very long spin down.
Yeah. Well, the Moss Caribbean Breeze technically is an industrial as well, the last one we tested.
Actually, Jeffrey just got a tap recently from Facebook Marketplace. He actually just posted a video of it on Facebook.
Yeah.
He actually showed one of my Silverline blades. So, probably once I get home, should be done, and I'll probably get it back. Well, of course I'm gonna get it back. These dunks, it's mine.
You're right, it is a very long spin down. But that means the bearings are in decent shape.
Yeah. Man, I really want to get a gold line.
Yeah, same here. Gold lines. I still long to get a gold line.
Yeah. Here's the only thing is, if you try to get one in Canada, like if you phone Envirofin in Oshkosh, in Canada, they won't ship it to Canada. Like Envirofin doesn't ship to Canada, because Jeffrey Robinson tried to get one. His mom phoned Envirofin, and they said they don't ship to Canada. Which kind of sucks. There's a lot of new places in Canada you do see gold lines. I don't know how they get them there. And actually, when I went to visit him, he did tell me he's getting a gold line from somewhere. I'm trying to remember what that place was, because whatever it was, I want to try and get a gold line there.
Was it like a grocery store or something?
No. It's not a place that, like, he's not a place he's like getting one down from. Like not a place
like a salvage or whatever.
I don't think it was salvage. I think it's actually a place that sells them.
Okay.
If I'm remembering correctly, that's what it sounded like he was saying. It's not like he's pulling one out of a place that's abandoned or it's a salvage place, that there is one. Okay, it's gonna stop.
Very soon, just not much longer. Oh, it's almost done. Alright, that's it, guys.
Alright, that's it. Thanks for watching. And please remember to comment, rate, and subscribe.